We have started definition of the technology, and we said that technology consists of two primary components. One of them is a physical component, which comprises of items such as products, tooling, equipment, blueprint, techniques, and processes. The second one, which is a little bit strange for us, for us means engineers, informal component, which consists of know-how, management, marketing, production, quality control, reliability, even skilled labor is considered. So I was explaining the quality of the device. I said MTBF, mean time between two failures. I repeat, mean time between two failures. So in 1 year, for example, if we have 10 among 1,000 computers, 10 of them coming for repairment, that means the time between those, we have 365 days in. So 10 of them is coming, so every 36 days one of them is coming, so MTBF is 36. Did you understand that? This is a well-known definition, MTBF. Just a moment. I will bring my iPad so I can write. Yazayım bakayım bir dakika burada. Daha zor oluyor. Yok. iPad'i getireceğim. Moment. Meantime, between saçma sapan şeyler oluyor burada. Bu tanımı öğrenin çocuklar. Reliability de en önemli. This is the number one definition between two failures. Between two fail yazdım, uzatmıyorum. Okay, so that is the definition. There are other definitions as well. For example, the early Rosenberg and Fichtek also consider technology as firm specific. Kursörümü takip edin lütfen. Firm specific information concerning the characteristics and performance properties of production processes and product design. Therefore, technology is tacit and cumulative in nature. Tacit enteresan bir kelime çocuklar. Kendiniz de bakarsınız. Neredeyim? Gene şeye gittim. Bayrak, tamam. Technology is also embodied in people, materials, cognitive. Of course, you know what cognitive is. Cognitive is the knowledge or methods relevant to brain. Cognitive science, for example. Brain activities, relevant to brain activities. Thinking is also is a cognitive behavior. And physical processes, facilities, machines, and tools. There are other concepts as well. For example, these people argues that technology and knowledge are inseparable simply because of their technological product is transferred or diffused the knowledge upon which it comprises is based upon. Çünkü gözlerim çok yaşardığı için okuyamıyorum, bir saniye. Biraz böyle nezle falan olunca göz acayip yaşarıyor. Tabii yaşarınca da mercek vazifesi görüyor o gözün üstündeki gözyaşı. Ve okuyamıyorum. Göremiyorum yani. Biraz da büyüteyim bakayım. Son cümleyi okuyayım. The physical entity cannot be put to use without the existence of knowledge base which is inherent and not ancillary. Evet, bu tanımlar böyle filozof şeyleri, biraz filosofi kısmı var. Ama bu gerçekçi bir that is the I'm sorry for Turkish. These are realistic definition of the technology. How could we develop a product? Since we know that product is the major example of the technology, so you can see that product requirement is coming from marketing department or some R&D policy defining department. Some people say that, for example, I personally used to say that in beginning, at the end of the 20th century, before the end of the 20th century, I personally used to say that the electric car era is going to be coming. Therefore, we have to hurry up and we have to develop the technology. That is what, when I was working at Scientific and Technological Research Council of Turkey, Marmara Research Center, I used to tell everyone, and also the automotive managers and things like this. I used to say that. So that is the requirement. But depends whether it turn out to be a product is completely different matter. So management actually, the management side decides that that kind of technology is important, therefore should be developed. There is no technology yet. Only there are scientific hints, ipuçları var, bilimsel ipuçları var. There is no technology yet. Then they say research and development department, they have to try on this one. Research and Development Department first start with basic research or follow the basic research results, update their knowledge, then they start designing a new product. Just assume that it's going to be an electric vehicle, for example. Or electric vehicle is a very complex one. Electric motor. Develop an electric motor to be used in electric vehicles. All right? So you are going to design the electric circuit. You are going to design the magnetic circuit. You are going to analyze the electromagnetic field theory inside it. Then you are going to optimize these things. Then you come a preliminary design, bir ön design, preliminary design. When you start, complete the preliminary design, you actually manufacture it in your lab, and then you make some experimental studies in your lab, laboratory. Your product is in the prototype level. Laboratory, then you are not happy. The performance is expected is not fulfilling your requirements. All right, come back, change the design, make another experiment. Then after laboratory and design process inside the R&D department, then you decided that you reached the optimum design. Of course, during that optimum design, generally cost calculations also should be taken into account. What would be the cost of this device, which should be competitive? Otherwise, you can't sell it. Anyway, when you decide that you reach the final form, then, of course, the production line is completely different matter. As long as you reach the best design of the electric motor, then you prepare the production line. So product design and drafting, then fabrication and assembling. Then when you form a fabrication line, you have got a product which actually output of the factory. But before at this stage, you also impose, you also make a lot of experiments. It's called quality. The quality department do this. So when those tests, some of them are called type tests, some of them are called ordinary tests. Ordinary test means, for example, whether there is a short circuit, what is the maximum voltage that resists your system, and then what would be the torque output, and that sort of. But type test is something you don't apply to every product. So you can see the maximum temperature, when you maximum load and things, these are called type tests. In every product it is done. So don't forget, two tests. One of them is simply just looking at whether there is a short circuit, no, and also, all right, run it, it's rotating, all right. Then, but among, for example, 100 of the products or thousands of the products, you pick one of them or two, three of them, and also apply the type tests as well. Type tests are heating, cooling, excessive loading, transient measurements, lots of things. At the end, your product is in the market. If there is a success there, all right, you are happy. But always, there is a feedback line going to back to management. Management always follow what is the success of the, you know, the marketing success. How much we sell? What about the prices of others? Are we getting profit from it? This is the one. But that is the technology development process. Okay. Now I continue. What does technology readiness level? What is S-curve? I'm going to come back to S-curve anyway, but let's concentrate on the technology readiness level. Generally, people don't say technology readiness level, they just say, TRL in English. So technology readiness level. Everybody understand if you write TRL or TR level. Technology readiness levels are a method for understanding the technological maturity of the technology during its acquisition phase. TRLs allow engineers to have a consistent datum of reference of understanding technology evolution, regardless of their technological ground. Şimdi buraya geri döneceğim, bakın. Şurada bunun teknolojik readiness level'ı 5'tir. Burada 0 tabii. 0'dan başlıyor. Burada ben ne yazsam bu kadar, siz de görüyor musunuz bu yazıyı bilmiyorum. Habire bu çıkıyor ve bana zaman kaybediyor. Bu burada 5'tir. Şurada 6'dır. Şurada 8'dir. Burada testi de geçtiyse 9'dur. 9 final. Final level. Final level. Technology readiness level. Bunu öğrenin ha çocuklar. Niye öğrenin diyorum? Why I'm saying that? Since we are applying for TÜBİTAK projects or European Union Horizon Europe projects. Every project defines that we expect technology readiness level 5, for example, or 6. But sometimes they say technology readiness level should be 9. So you have to be careful which technological readiness level you are going to fulfill. Technology readiness level. Okay. Şimdi ona döneceğim gene. Technology readiness level'a. Burada. 1. Basic principles of principles observed. 2. I'm sorry. Second. Technology concept formulated. 3. Experimental proof of concept. So a new concept you are going to apply and you are going to convert it to technology. The first three here. This is called research. I repeat. Basic principles first. So mathematical background, scientific background. So these are all research. And also formulation. And also some experimental proof of concept. Not there's no product at all, but you are making research about it. Now the second phase is the development phase. Technology validated in lab, technology validated in relevant environments. So you are also putting some devices and things like this. Technology demonstrated in relevant environment. Technology validated, başka bir şey, is something different. Demonstrated is something different. Validated, doğrulamak demek biliyorsunuz in Turkish. So you are validating the technology in different applications as well. But then you demonstrate it. So if you reach the technology readiness level 6, that means it is ready for the production line. End of 6 is ready for the production line. End of 7, buraya tekrar geri döneceğim. Bakın six dedim buraya. Yani artık bundan sonra production line'a geçecek. Şurası da 7 aslında. Onu da koyayım madem böyle. Arda arda gidiyor. So for seventh deployment. Deployment tuhaf bir kelime biliyorsunuz deployment. Mesela şey askeri de terim aynı zamanda. Units are deployed near the battlefield. Bunlar buraya yerleştirildi, kondu, konma, gerçekleştirme falan. Yerine koyma. System prototype demonstration in operational environment. So there is a prototype here in six as well. But that prototype is now in operational area. You put it in operational area. For example, you develop an electric motor. What are you going to do? In order to develop electric motor, you are going to first read the articles and also learn about the field theory, electromagnetic field theory, circuit theory, and try to develop the design principles of it. So technology concept formulated, then you try to reach the design studies as well. So you have to prove that those laws, for example, the electromagnetic field theories applied for that one. Then you start develop some prototype in the lab, and then you test it in some loading experiments. So you test it is whether it's verified in your lab as well, and also you demonstrate in different far the various relevant environment. Then you be sure that for example, some heating experiments, some torque experiments, and everything. When you complete it or changing the speed, for example, in response time, transients, and things like this, you measure. You are in the lab. In development stage, you are in the lab, laboratory. But here, you are going out and then system prototype demonstration. So you put your power electronics and electric machine control system, you put it in a car, actually. But of course, now technology is very much changed. There is a stage, software in the loop, hardware in the loop, a driver in the loop, that's still in computational area. We have now artificial vehicle as well. So we put our electric motor, which is a real motor, but we apply it as if the vehicle is over there in artificial environment. Artificial model of the electric vehicle, we put actual. So this is called hardware in the loop. Hardware means electric motor, but loop is the vehicle. Anyway, so if you come here, system is complete and qualified. Also, the lot of product is complete, and you apply all known standard tests. If your product satisfies those standard tests, which are declared by various institutions, the quality control, globally quality control institutions there are, and those institutions experiment items, if your product satisfy and pass all those requirements, then you are going to sell it, then you are going to say that it's in the market. Actual system proven in operational environment. Operational environment means now. It's a ninth level is the final level. Burada ne var bakacağım ona göre. Oh yes, it's explaining. Şurada bir saniye. Acık boğazım kurudu. Level 1. Basic principles observed, scientific observations made and reported. Examples could include paper-based studies on a technology basic properties. Research. Sorry. Second one, technology concept formulated, envisioned applications are speculate at this stage. Examples are often limited to analytical studies. Hala şey, analitik denklemler vesaire, equations and things like this. Third one, experimental proof of concept. A proof of concept, çünkü tam Türkçesi, güzel bir Türkçesi yok aslında. Yani kavramın doğrulanması diyelim, tamam mı? Yani ama kavramın, yani uygulanması düşünülen kavramı, I'm sorry for Turkish, those concept you think that is going to be applied is experimentally verified. In lab, you are still in the lab, in laboratory. Effective research and development initiated. Examples include studies and laboratory measurements to validate analytical predictions. So at this stage, you are leaving the lab and you are now turning to the factory level. Technology validated in lab, technology validated through designed investigation. Examples might include analysis of the technology parameter. Buraya artık geldik, şeye geçtik. Bitti, laboratuvara geldik esas. Buradan 4, 5, 6 biliyorsunuz verification. Geri dönüyorum. Burası. 4. 4. 4 de şurada. 4 de hemen burada. 4. 5. Şurası 5 and 6 burası. 4, 5, 6. So 4, 5, 6 bu bölge. Bakın 4, 4, 5, 6 development stage. Technology validated in lab. Technology validated through, this is the name, by the way. Technology validated through design investigation. Examples might include analysis of technology parameters, operation range. The results provide evidence that envisioned application performance requirement might be attainable. Uzun lafın kısası, your design is tested in laboratory environment and to see whether it satisfies the required values or not. The fifth stage, you are still in the lab. Sorry about that. Technology validated in relevant environment. Reliability of technology significantly increases. So you are looking for bugs. So you would like to improve your, you make a lot of experiments and to make corrections, change some design parameters. Examples could involve validation of a semi-integrated system, model of technological and supporting elements in a simulated environment. Simulation is also involving here as well during the design stage. Particularly the development of the technology, for example, for electric motor, you cannot design an electric motor without finite element analysis or without using softwares developed to design an electric motor. Without using those softwares, you cannot design an electric motor by hand. You are still in the lab, sixth one. Technology demonstrated in relevant environments, prototype system verified. Examples might include a prototype system model-based product produced and demonstrated in a simulated environment. This simulation is also important, but you probably in your future, you are going to take part in some research institutes. Don't rely upon, of course, there are a lot of very high quality simulation tools, or MATLAB, for example, is one of them. LabVIEW is another one. We generally use MATLAB in our teaching system, and I believe it is one of the mostly developed best environment to do that. But for power system analysis, for example, we have some electric people here as well. You may go to electric power system operation, energy production, and things like this. Of course, there are programs, special programs to simulate electric power system as well. Anyway, so software support is important. When you complete that one, you are in the technology development, technology, let's say, factory level or application level. System model or prototype demonstration in operational environment. Operational environment means application. You put your electric motor in a car. Okay? This is what you are doing. A major step increase in technological, so we are thinking that we are developing electric motor and power electronic drive system together. That's why I said you put it in an electric vehicle. A major step increase in technological maturity. So when you test it, you see that torque is not enough, for example, or excessive heating, you can see there's something funny, or losses getting higher, whatever it is, then you improve your system as well. But in the meantime, you are preparing the factory production line as well. For seven, examples could include a prototype model system being verified in an operational environment. So operational environment that you are actually testing your device in operating place. For electric vehicle, for example, since we assume that we are developing power electronics and an electric machine to be used for electric vehicles, then we put it in an electric vehicle and we run it and we test it. If we satisfy with those, then that means we are reaching the final stage. Then the whatever the system would be should satisfy the standards. Quality control standards. There are quality control standards. System complete and qualified. Look, eight is just before the selling stage. System, from now on, system is complete and qualified. system model produced and qualified. An example might include the knowledge generated from TRL-7 being used to manufacture an actual system model, which is subsequently qualified in an operational environment. In most cases, this TRL represents the end of development. Bak bu cümle çok önemli. In most cases, this TRL, TRL 8 yani, represent the end of development. You are not going to improve the product from now on. You say that we reached the final case. But 9 is the final case, which is now you can sell your device. Actual system proven in operational environment, system model proven and ready for full commercial deployment. Satışa hazır. An example includes the actual system model being successfully developed for multiple mission by end users. Of course, those multiple mission, of course, if you develop a small microcontroller, for example, that microcontroller might be used for battery management system, so to control the battery energy, or that tiny little microcontroller might be used, or microprocessor, whatever it is, might be used to control the electric vehicle as well, electric motor as well, or robotic arm. So it might be used in various environments as well. That's why they call it like this. So that these stages are important. Before starting that one, I would like to come back to this point. What is S-curve? Evet, bir acele etmeyin, bir dosya yüklüyorum. Evet, başladı yüklemeye. S-curve is a very famous curve, which is widely used in industry to evaluate the benefit of the product or value add, katma değer, quality of the product. Doldurdum acaba ya? Evet, koymuş. Bunları dosyalayacağım sonra. Şeye koyacağım, oylarını. Sorry. Ne dersiniz çocuklar? Hiç ara vermeden yürüyüp varacağım yere kadar geldiğimde bitirelim mi? Artık bilmiyorum. Onu çeyrek geçe mi, 20 geçe mi, buçukta mı biter? When we complete the course as early as possible, it's all right. So I continue. Okay. What is technology S-curve in product design? So we are dealing with design of the product, and we have already seen TRL levels. We have already seen the development of TRL levels. Now, what's technology S-curve? The technology S-curve determines the performance in regards to time and effort. Oh. Determines the performance in regards to time and effort. It assists in determining the level of maturity of the industry product. Let us discuss more details on these technology S-curves. So it reflects the maturity. Maturity ne demek? Olgunluk demek. So your technological quality, technological level or some kind of relevance to the financial success as well. But what's happening actually, that part here, this part, that part is basic research. Then this part is technology development stage. When you make your product ready and start selling it, so that means you are not technologically improving the product. So product is not changing anymore. So what's happening actually, this curve is reaching its saturation. You are not adding a new knowledge, new know-how inside the technology. That is what S-curve is all about. Şunu bir temizleyeyim. So the basic research and the product development stage, ikinci slide'da geçtiğimizde göreceksiniz neler olduğunu. Evet, anlatıyor zaten. Phase A, Phase B, and Phase C. There are three phases, as I explained. But this is the performance of the product. And that is the technological limit. For example, semiconductor development. You develop a semiconductor, let's say MOSFET or thyristor or IGBT, insulated gate bipolar transistor. So you make a basic research in lab, then you develop your system. While you are developing, the technological level getting up all the time. But here, when you reach a certain level, now you prepare your product and you start selling it, then the new know-how to put inside that technology or device, a new know-how is limited. So the acceleration, the performance increase is Limited. This is phase C. Şimdi phase A, phase C'ye bakalım ne yazmış, onu da okuyalım. Stages of technology S-curve. A low portion. A kısmı. This phase is beginning of the S-curve pattern of innovation. That one is, it might also be considered the level of innovation as well. It is when the product industry is completely new. As a result, a dominant stage in the market hasn't been established yet. Bakın bu cümle çok önemli. As a result, a dominant design in the market hasn't been established yet. Therefore, the competition between the various players in the industry is fierce. Şimdi bu mesela neyi andırıyor? Sony Walkman çıkarmıştı hatırlarsanız. If you remember the Walkman. So when they study, there is a need. What's the need? Human requires to listen music while on park, while on walking everywhere. So then Sony has decided that it should be fulfilled with portable tape. It's called, neydi ya? Şimdi söylemiştim. Walkman. It's a Walkman. It's a tape but small, that size. So you put it in your pocket and also you have earphones. That's all. But for this one, they make a research. To make it small tape, and then they develop the technology. So innovation level is high. Then they sell it, and they realize for this point, it's not you cannot improve further. So technological limit is reached. All right. Let's continue phase A to it phase A. As a result, usually at this stage, most of the resources are spent on research and development. There will be apparent not much innovation. There will be apparently not much innovation. Not yet. This is a basic research. Changes are less and widely spaced. However, middle portion, which is a product development part, due to the ability to overcome a major technical obstacle or the ability to satisfy a demand of the market in this space, the product industry has been adopted by the early majority and managed to cross the differences, and dominant design has been established already. So a new product, a new concept you develop. Of course, the Walkman was a new concept at that time. Hence, the market will be characterized by rapid growth in production, and the product will move quickly towards a full market acceptance. So it's already in the market now. In this stage, it's already in the market. Okay. So this performance is not only representing the technological level. This performance is also representing the profit or market success. Okay. You have to understand that one. S-curve is a very famous representation. Be careful. That I repeat, this phase, your product is in the market, and all of a sudden you have got a lot of profit from it, and your product selling figures are very high. And probably it's an innovative product. Nobody has done it before. Therefore, you are selling quite high numbers. Market success as well. So a rapid profusion of innovation will take place during this period. Many products are launched and many competitors join the market. Şimdi sen bunu yaptığın zaman sen bunu when you develop Walkman for example, the others are also looking at it and they say why don't we do that? Then they also imitate your work. And although the work is protected by patents, nevertheless, it's not very difficult to provide something similar, but not violating the patent rights. Okay. Then phase C, your gain is limited now. Aşağıdaki şekli görmenizi istemiyorum. Çünkü o önemli bir şey açıklayacak. Maturity. Here the product is adopted almost completely by society and is usually approaching a physical limit. So there is no change. So you are manufacturing it. Then for example you are manufacturing in United States, but in China, for example, or even in Turkey, let's say, since we our cost added values are lower, therefore we produce that device with a lower price. Okay, so rival companies are also manufacturing things due to strong competition. This is what I mean. Among the major players in the market, which is clearly defined at this stage, most of the resources at this point are spent on improving the production processes and making them cheaper. The others are making them cheaper, so they don't spend too many R&D expenses since you manufacture it and they look at it, they imitate it. So therefore, oftentimes the product of this stage become completely standardized and the innovations at this stage are considered incremental. Şuradayız. So what are you going to do as a company? Even at this point, you have to start to make another research. Or another company, for example, Apple. Apple developed, neydi onun adı? Ya küçük şeyler, müzik dinleme aletleri vardı. Neydi onun adı ya? What's the name of it? Herkes onu, siz tabii hep cep telefonundan dinliyorsunuz artık. Ondan evvel bir teknoloji daha var. iPad. iPad değil ya. Çocuklar yardım etsenize. I'm asking you, what was the device developed by Apple for listening music? What was the name of it? iPad. Was it iPad? Okay, thank you. So, here at this point, some other company or your company, start basic research on why should I use tape instead of we are going to store knowledge in hardware, then we are going to provide a good transmission music or storing music when the first 1, 2, 3 technological level were completed, then technology 4, 5, 6 for this one, then immediately you put another device, rival device. But that curve becomes sharply going down. Actually, It doesn't remain like this. It goes down. Sorry. So that new technology in the meantime becomes very dominant, and then another commercial success. So this technology becomes obsolete, no use, and lose the market share, and that new technology becomes like this. You can see, you have already seen that. For example, for cell phones, first Ericsson and Nokia was the top companies, and Motorola in United States, US company. Then Blackboard, was it Blackburn, Canadian company, provided something additional. It was better, but all of a sudden, when iPhone introduced, this is the iPhone technology now. But now iPhone technology came to hit this one, although there's still room to improve, since it's a lot of softwares involving with those kind of telephones. So however, that one, for example, is Oppo. This one is a Chinese, and also other, particularly the Korean, for example, company is developed. So that's, the technology has changed, and then when they reach this one, another technology came. This one is iPad. That one is iPad, for example. This one is kalem nerede ha? Biraz küçültelim bunu ya. 5 punto ne bu? iPad technology. However, that one here is not, since now is not used, cell phone technology is, for this part I'm talking about, cell phone technology is developed earlier, of course, but cell phone technology now take over, and all the music is also stored in your cell phones, and nobody is using iPad anymore. So iPad also lost its. Şunun rengini değiştireyim ben. So the S curves are representing the, not only it's called performance, that means commercial success as well. This one is Walkman. Sony. Apple. Apple's. Korelilerinkinin ismi neydi ya çocuklar ya? Ben de kullandım. Telefon. Korelilerin telefonun ismi neydi? Samsung tabii ya. Samsung, Huawei. Huawei'yi nasıl yazıyoruz? Bir baksanıza cep telefonundan. Y var mı burada? Huawei. Tamam. Tamam, sağ olun çocuklar. Yine de yanlış yazdım galiba. Bakacağım şimdi. Huawei. Evet, onu silelim bakalım. Şimdi mesela saat, normal saatler, clutch, clock. Şimdi mesela that is also very innovative product. Oppo is my phone, for example. Şimdi burada da enteresan bir şey paylaşmak istiyorum. First, of course, I used to have Ericsson. My first phone was Ericsson. I could use it in my car as well. So it was very practical. Then I decided that I should use Microsoft applicable cell phone. So I bought a cell phone which was very nice. However, since the software is Microsoft relevant, is not the proper software in it. So I lot of time I used to not to get a cell phone calls and things like this. So at the end, I was very happy that I was thinking. You see, technology prediction is very important. I was thinking that the Microsoft communication capability, which is successful in computers, would be applied in cell phones as well. It was a wrong prediction. It was a wrong decision. Then I have to change it. Then Blackboard, neyse o Canadian. So I use that one. Then at the end, it's all became absolute, nothing used. So this one, I used to have Samsung, and that Samsung was, you see, also one thing is interesting in technology. The technology development time is very fast for those, but also those cell phones are all of a sudden become out of fashion. A new model is coming. So that's a lot of changes occurs in cell phones as well. However, if you develop a vehicle, for example, developing process takes years to develop a vehicle. I'm familiar with the automotive business. Then it takes a lot of year to change the models. However, in telephone, for example, every 1 or 2 years, a new model is coming. So this is a kind of response time or time constant of the product. Bakayım bunu bitirdim mi ya? Evet, aşağıda bir şeyler daha var. Onları da okuyayım size. Ben zaten söyleneceği söyledim ama. At this phase of discontinuity, innovation occurs and new S-curve pattern can rise. Since the previous product reaches an era of maturity, there is no opportunity for new product to appeal to the innovator segment and they will start the new product life cycle. Which is usually considered as the disruption. Çocuklar, bu disruption kelimesi, altını çiziyorum. Disruption. Bu yani disruption'ı öğrenin. Disruption is a kind of thing that when you provide a new technology, that technology puts all the other technologies into the rubbish bin. Garbage. Şimdi Amerikalılar garbage der, İngilizler rubbish der. Rubbish bin, çöp kutusuna atar. Tamam mı? In Turkish. If you develop, Türkçe söyleyeceğim. Eğer bir yeni ürün çıkartırsanız, bu yeni ürün eğer disruptifse, buna disruption deniyor. Kırılma, teknolojide kırılma anlamına geliyor disruption. Öbür teknolojileri çöpün içine atar. Bu, bakın burada var. Mesela bunlar hep disruption örnekleri. Walkman become disrupted and iPad even disappeared. Now in cell phones, there are a lot of companies couldn't be survive since new technology, this particularly the Apple technology, which touch you are doing things by touching the cell phone, dominated the market. Okay, so this is what technology development. The example audio industry they say. Bakalım neymiş, bir görelim ne yazmışız. Ha, burada koymuşlar ya. Ama bu biraz eskidir. Dur bakalım ne çıkacak. It might be a bit. Evet. Önce tape, sonra iPhone, so I'm sorry, Walkman, sonra iPad, sonra bunları demiş. Bu da mature. Bakın şimdi burada da ben size söyleyeyim. Şu yeni kompütür aldım. Şey yok içinde. Disk reading facility is not put down. So storing knowledge, technology has changed great deal as well. So this is not used anymore. So this one, there is another curve here. Biraz incelteyim şunu. Tamam, dursun. There is another curve here. It's all put in the cell phones. That one is disappeared. That one is disappeared. Disappearing rather. Since flash memories are widely used now to store something. So a new technology here. Evet, burayı yazmış. Ben conclusion o. Siz artık yani bu işleri biliyorsunuz. The discontinuity phase appeared when Sony and Philips have developed the compact disc and by doing so disrupted the market and started new S-curve. That is also disrupted. That is also disrupted by flash memories. Okay. It says Sony has invented the Walkman that had the ability to answer the customer demand of listening to the cassette outside. As a result of Sony's success, the market has arrived at its maturity. As a number of competitors manufacture similar devices, Philips, Sony, TDK, Maxwell, etc., the discontinuity phase appeared when Sony and Philips have developed the compact disc. There is one more sentence required for this one. Probably this one, I picked this note, is old. Interesting. Even you can see even the notes or papers or books are becoming disrupted. Disruption is very important. Okay. Bakayım nereye geldim. Bu bitti. Evet, biz de yorulduk. Bakalım, bir bakacağım şimdi neredeyiz. Bunu okuyayım ama çocuklar dinleyin. The technology S-curve of innovation product life cycle is a robust framework that can be used to analyze various products at their different stages and to explain their successes and failures. If you still have any further thoughts on this topic, please let us know on the comment section below. Yok, gerek yok ya. Comment, moment. Hepiniz Çin gibisiniz. Hepsiniz, you all understand what's going on. Şu şeyimi açayım tekrar, dosyamı. Bir dakika. Galileo'lardan falan geldik buralara. I'm sorry. Newton'lar, Galileo'lar derken Faraday, teknolojiye başladık. Teknoloji readiness level'ı gördük. S-curve'ı gördük. Teknoloji readiness level'ı iyi inceledik. Invention nedir? How we protect intellectual property rights? What is innovation? Yok, burada kalalım biz. Ben size yalnız bir şey daha göstereyim. Ya da buradan sonra devam edeceğiz çocuklar. Tamam mı? Artık keselim derse. Bir yoklama alacağım yalnız. Yok olmayın. Muhammed Ali Apkara, onu da alıyorum. Yunus Emre'ye son isim. Abdülbari Abdülbaset de first isim, first name. Sakın gitmeyin ha, çünkü ben bunu yerleştiriyorum şeye, yoklamayı, ondan sonra. Evet, son isim şeyi aldı, Muhammed Ali Abkar'ı. Ayrılmış ama var gösterdim onu da. Abdülbari de ilk isim. Tamam. Dolayısıyla artık ayrılabilirsiniz. Ben de unutmadan şu kaydı keseyim. Hoşça kalın çocuklar. Cumhuriyetin kıymetini bilelim. Çok değerli, çok. Sağ ol Cemile. Kaydı kestim. Pardon, kesmedim.